So now every time the kick hits, the sub bass is going to duck. So if I turn, I'll just turn the solo off on the kick so we can just hear the sub bass and never listen. Doesn't sound very good on its own, but let's put the kick in. And if we bring in the high end of the bass, the high end of the bass doesn't have this little drop in volume, because it doesn't need to, because it doesn't have any low frequencies. Remember, in this EQ8, we took them out, with this high-pass filter. So this is making up for the lack of these notes. Even though we don't have a sub-bass playing on the first note or whenever there's a kick, this one makes up for it, and it kind of sounds like it's still playing, which is exactly what we're on. So that's kind of cool, ducking the bass, and that's just a quick little tip to get your mix sounding pretty good straight away. So that's the kick. I'm just going to go right ahead and add in a snare drum here because we should speed through and progress the tune. So just like before, I'm going to insert a MIDI track. I'm going to call this MIDI track snare, and we're going to insert a simpler just like before. So let's put in a simpler. And let's go find a sample. So we go to my samples directory, and let's go snare. And this will list all the snare drums. Again, you can just download this Ableton pack. You don't have to find your own samples. I will include these samples for you in the back. Quick stop. Let's just scroll down and hear some snares. So I'm just looking for one that I think will suit. I can be very picky sometimes. That's quite a cool one. Alright, so I'm going to drag that down to where it says drop sample here into the sim-